Today we are going to prepare the nanopaper or MFC paper using the Exilva microfibrillated cellulose, and we target to use a concentration of 0.05 weight percent. And for that purpose, I'm going to use only 9.8 grams of Exilva. And now we need to dilute it to 350 grams of water. Voila. And now we need to do mixing of our solution. The second step is to do mixing of our suspension. For that reason, we're going to use the ultratorix equipment. Today we're going to try the KTH conditions, and they're actually 12,500 RPM for 10 minutes. And now I'm going to adjust the speed, very gentle, step by step. And I start the timer. Let it mix. So now we have to prepare the filtration unit, DuraPore filter paper. Yeah, you see? Okay, and I also need to adjust the levels to make sure that our nanopaper will be uniform and homogeneous in all directions. So now our suspension is well prepared and mixed with the ultratorix, and I will just pour it in the filtration unit. So you see the material already starts to filter. In the beginning it always happens quite quick, but with the time when the first monolayers of MFC are formed on the membrane, the process will slow down. So we just need to wait a little bit, something like 20 minutes. Let's see how much time it will take to filter. So you see the filtration process is finished, nothing is dripping from the nozzle. It took only 15 minutes, which is good. So now let's disassemble the unit. Done. So here it is, sitting on top of our membrane. I put the membrane on top. Yes. And now we're ready to go to the rapid cutting equipment where we will dry the MFC paper. Okay, now it's time to dry our MFC paper or nanopaper in the rapid cutting equipment. So the temperature is 93 degrees Celsius. I'm placing the gel cake inside the equipment and starting up. The drying will take 15 minutes. I open the rapid cutting sheet former. Let's see what we have. Here is the paper. You see, it's almost transparent.